Robots use motors, pumps, hydraulics, and a lot of many different systems to move. However, that really makes them big, heavy, and bulky, and very expensive. However, Robotallic do not use this stuff. It uses something clever and different. This is its novelty. A while ago, I published a video that showcased the first ever Robotallic concept. This video is a follow-up to the progress to the same exact project. I highly recommend you watch that one first, and then watch this one. This way you will have a complete idea on how Robotallic works. Let's start with the design. So there is the upper top part, which is the main section of the robot. Two additional pieces, where each one will hold two legs securely to the top part of the robot, as well as providing a common ground. In other words, it's just another way for all the electricity to go back to the power source that provides all the power to the robot. Where each leg here is made out of five parts. We have the foot, we have the lower muscle, we have the knee, and we have the upper muscle, and we have the knee magnet. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get these magnets in time, so I had to work without them. Robotallic is very small. It's only 3.5 cm by 2 cm. And with a height of 2.7 cm, that makes it smaller than a 9-volt battery. And all that is just 4 grams. By the way, a 9-volt battery weighs 34 grams, which makes the robot 30 grams less than a 9-volt battery. So I will start the demo by showing a basic mode that has been tested before. It can lean backward, we see here, and an attempt to go above a very basic obstacle. Let's see how the robot is walking. Basically, there's a couple of ways to move the robot, either by using the upper muscles only or using the lower muscles only. The best that I have found so far is to make them all work together in a sequence, as we can see here. However, there is two types. There is the short stretches, which will make it the robot walk in a smooth surface. It will make it walk faster, and it will be like hopping. Like this save you see here, for example. The robot is normally controlled by the best prototyping tool in history, Arduino, and 8 relay module. There is also 2 power supplies, one for the relay module and the other one for the robot. For best functionality to the robot, it uses 2 amps of current at 15 volt as a minimum supply. A higher current was used when more than one muscle is activated, but it kept like at 4 amps at 15 volts. The longer stretches will actually enable the robot to go in a rougher surface, like this paper tape for example. And it will also make the robot be able to go above obstacles and stretch more, it slicks higher and so on. It obviously can go backwards just by reversing the algorithm of the control sequence, as you can see here. Achieving a higher speed is possible. Just by having a flexible high current wire, like I need a wire that is thick but super flexible, or thin but it can really handle high current. If you have any suggestions, please let me know. If you can see here, when I'm moving the legs that uses thinner wires, you can see them move very freely with no strain or lock applied to them. But the other leg that uses only one, I did not also solder the other two, you can see it barely moving at all. That's why I just stuck with the thinner wires. Well, these materials actually could flex really fast with the proper power applied to them. Here is a clip while I was trying to use a higher current. As you can see, it did flex super fast, but unfortunately the magic smoke was there. It was just the price to pay, you know. These wires cannot handle more than 3 amps. Even 3 amps for only 4 second burn. The heat maps that you can see here while the robot was walking really good, it shows a really good results because it only reaches around 67°C. And the older model, by the way, was in 106, I think, 106C. So there is also a better performance in terms of temperature. Overall, I really think this version of Robotallic is better because it uses less power, it can do more, and it has 8 fully enhanced functional muscles. Not only that, it's easily made, repaired, and modified. This is a huge plus, as I can now keep testing the same model and learn before moving to the next one.